Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Patki and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to take a look at what were the most expensive buys in the IPL auction 2024, which took place on December the 19th in Dubai. Actually, I wanted to make that video a long time ago, but due to my academic commitments, I couldn't do that. So sorry for that. This video is a little bit late, but hopefully I can provide you the thorough analysis and at what player, at they went for what price and to which team, I'm going to tell you all in this video. So first of all, we will start with the most expensive one, no doubt, Mitchell Starc, who will be playing the 2024 edition of the IPL after an 8-year hiatus. He actually went for a mind-boggling rupees 24.75 crore, that is roughly $2.98 million, so almost $3 million, to Kolkata Knight Riders. And we have to see the tide shifting in terms of player getting hefty salaries. Mr. Sanjeev Goenka, actually, who is the owner of the Lucknow Super Giants, said that the market conditions actually influenced the price. The same reason was given by Venky Mysore, who is the CEO of Kolkata Knight Riders as well. And actually, Mr. Sanjeev Goenka said that it might not be long that in the next season someone might breach the elusive 25 crore barrier as well. We don't have to forget that just 3 or 4 years ago, the maximum that every franchise that could spend, the limit set by the BCCI was just rupees 60 crore. Now it has been increased to 90 crore rupees due to the excellent money flowing in as a reason of the digital rights, television rights, as well as the overseas rights, which are currently being controlled by the Reliance Group, that is Viacom 18 and Jio TV. But before that, they were under the influence of Star India actually. And Star India and Reliance, that is Disney, has also decided to merger, but that is a different topic altogether. Now we will come to the second most expensive player, that is Mr. Pat Cummins, who went for $2.47 million, that is 20 crore 50 lakh rupees, to Sunrisers Hyderabad. So both of the Australians fast bowlers making merry due to their magnificent performance right from 2023. We have to take into consideration the ODI World Cup, the Ashes as well, and whatever T20 bilateral series Australia has played, Mitchell Starc and Pat Cummins, actually, due to the workload management, they weren't used to feature in them most of the time. But since 2-3 years, they have religiously played the T20 format, where Australia is taking part international games, and they both were a pivotal part of the side that won the T20 World Cup in 2021. So they deserve that kind of money. Mitchell Starc actually said in a video that he's still humbling to feel that I'm wanted or needed. That has to be the most humble statement for a guy who has earned 24.75 crore rupees and who is the most expensive player now in IPL history. I actually also made a video that this pricing is up to the franchises, no doubt. But does Indian player feel a little bit sad? Now, in my humble opinion, if Mitchell Starc's net worth is 24.75 crore, due to the loyalty that Virat Kohli commands in Royal Challengers Bangalore, that number could have been 35 crore, 36 crore. Mumbai Indians could also pay the same kind of 35, 36, 37 crore to Rohit Sharma for his excellent services since 2011 to the franchises. So that is, there comes a little bit of ambiguity, but it is what it is. They already get a retainer's fee because some number of players are retained. Some contrast is also there. We remember that last year Yash Dayal was smashed by 5 sixes by Rinku Singh in KKR versus Lucknow Super Giant at the Narendra Modi Stadium. But after that, in this auction, Yash Dayal actually went for 5 crore rupees, and as a retainer player, Rinku Singh just got rupees 55 lakh rupees. So there are some discrepancies. Hopefully the IPL governing council will address it in the next session going forward. Darrell Mitchell, one of the most expensive buys, went for 14 crore to the Chennai Super Kings. As we know, he had a great World Cup, only player to score 2 centuries against India in the World Cup. We don't have to forget that, and he has been performing consistently well in the white ball format as well. Harshal Patel, who was released by Royal Challengers Bangalore, went to Punjab Kings for 11.75 crore rupees. As we know that he plays domestic cricket for Haryana only, so he might be familiar in that kind of pitches in northern India. So PBKS has put a big punt on him. Aljari Joseph, the fast bowler, West Indian fast bowler, who used to ply his trade for Lucknow Super Giant, now RCB has shelled out 11.50 crore rupees on him. Samir Rizvi, द बैट्समैन फ्रॉम उत्तर प्रदेश हु इज ऑल्सो नोन एज द राइट हैंडेड सुरेश रैना हैज परफॉर्म्ड एक्सीलेंटली वेल इन द सैयद मुश्ताक अली ट्रॉफी एज वेल एज द विजय हजारे ट्रॉफी इम्प्रेस्ड वन एंड ऑल इन द लिमिटेड अपॉर्चुनिटीज ही गॉट प्लेइंग फॉर उत्तर प्रदेश इन द रणजी ट्रॉफी एज वेल ही वेंट फॉर 8.4 करोड़ रुपीज एक्सीलेंट स्टोरी ही इज नॉट इवन 21 ईयर्स ओल्ड बट ही डिजर्व्स इट ड्यू टू द हम्बल बैकग्राउंड ही कम्स फ्रॉम कुमार कुशाग्रा वेंट फॉर फ्रॉम झारखंड वेंट फॉर 7.2 करोड़ टू डेली कैपिटल्स कुमार कुशाग्रा इज अ राइट हैंडेड विकेट कीपर बैट्समैन जस्ट 19 ईयर्स ओल्ड बट ही हैज़ कम्प्लीटली सेट द डोमेस्टिक सीन ऑन फायर इन इंडिया एंड होपफुली बेटर थिंग्स आर कम टू हिम सनराइजर्स हैदराबाद एक्चुअली स्पेंट 7.4 करोड़ ऑन अ गुजर प्लेयर एज वेल सो ऑल इन ऑल प्रिटी एक्सपेंसिव एवरीथिंग रॉबिन मिन्स इज अ विकेट कीपर फ्रॉम झारखंड हु गॉट 3.60 करोड़ रुपीज इन द ऑक्शन गुजरात टाइटन्स एक्चुअली टूक हिम आई थिंक ही इज अ बैकअप विकेट कीपर फॉर विद्यमान शाह दैट विल बी अ गुड ऑप्शन शाहरुख खान आई बेग योर पार्डन वेंट फॉर 7.4 करोड़ रुपीज इन गुजरात टाइटन्स दे आर ट्राइंग टू फिल द वॉइड ऑफ हार्दिक पांड्या एज वी नो शाहरुख खान यूज टू प्ले फॉर पंजाब किंग्स एंड ही प्लेड प्रिटी गुड इनिंग्स डाउन दी ऑर्डर ओवर द ईयर्स फॉर देम बट फिलिंग द शूज ऑफ हार्दिक पांड्या इज अ डिफरेंट मैटर ऑल टुगेदर एंड होपफुली फ्रॉम गुजरात टाइटन्स परस्पेक्टिव शाहरुख खान विल एक्चुअली प्ले बेटर फॉर देम सो या मुजीबुर रहमान वेंट फॉर 2 करोड़ रुपीज टू कोलकाता नाइट राइडर्स आई थिंक सो दैट इट्स अ प्रिटी फेयर प्राइस वन इन टू हसरंगा वॉज अ स्टील फॉर सनराइजर्स दे मस्ट बी फीलिंग वेरी लकी दे एक्चुअली स्पेंड 20.5 करोड़ रुपीज फॉर पैट कमिंस बट गॉट 1 into हसरंगा इन जस्ट 1.5 करोड़ रुपीज ट्रैविस हेड द वर्ल्ड कप हीरो हु ब्रोक काउंटलेस इंडियन हार्ट्स वेंट टू सनराइजर्स हैदराबाद एज वेल बोथ द ऑस्ट्रेलियन प्लेयर्स हु प्लेड अ पिवोटल पार्ट इन दैट फाइनल वेंट टू सनराइजर फॉर 6.8 करोड़ रुपीज रचिन रविंद्र हु सेट्स द वर्ल्ड कप स्टेज ऑन फायर बिकेम द ओनली बैट्समैन इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ द वर्ल्ड कप हुज फर्स्ट एडिशन यील्डेड 3 सेंचुरीज 1.8 करोड़ टू सी एस के सो दैट्स अ चीप बाय एज वेल कंपेयरिंग टू द पोटेंशियल शार्दुल ठाकुर वंस अगेन रिटर्न्स टू द सी एस के फोल्ड 4 करोड़ रुपीज दैट इज फेयर इनफ अमाउंट मुस्तफिजुर रहमान वॉज ऑल्सो पिकड अप बाय चेन्नई ही मस्ट बी प्रिटी यूजफुल इन द स्लोअर ट्रैक्स दैट चेपक ऑफर्स 2 करोड़ रुपीज जेराल्ड कोट्ज़ा हु हैज इम्प्रेस्ड वन एंड ऑल थ्रू आउट द वर्ल्ड कप वेंट फॉर 5 करोड़ रुपीज मुंबई इंडियंस गॉट हिज सर्विसेज नुवान थुसारा एज वेल वेंट फॉर 4.8 करोड़ रुपीज एंड गुड टू सी दैट श्रीलंकन प्लेयर्स आर मेकिंग कम बैक टू द आई पी एल एज वी नो दैट श्रीलंका वेन वॉज नॉट प्लेइंग अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर पोटेंशियल ओनली लसित मलिंगा वॉज द श्रीलंकन प्लेयर सो गुड टू सी श्रीलंका क्रिकेट ऑन द राइज अगेन दिलशान मधुशंका हु इम्प्रेस्ड वन एंड ऑन इन द वर्ल्ड कप एज वेल स्लिंगी लेफ्ट आमर 4.6 करोड़ ही वेंट टू मुंबई इंडियंस एंड 1.5 करोड़ वॉज वेंट फॉर मुंबई फॉर मोहम्मद नाबी एज वेल शुभम दुबे नॉट शिवम दुबे शुभम दुबे अ बैट्समैन फ्रॉम विदर्भ एक्चुअली वेंट फॉर 27 ईयर ओल्ड बैट्समैन हु एक्चुअली डिडेंट इवन हैव मनी टू बैट अ बाय जस्ट 2 मंथ्स बिफोर द आई पी एल ऑक्शन वेंट फॉर 5 करोड़ 80 लाख रुपीज ही वॉज पिक्ड अप बाय राजस्थान रॉयल्स एंड दैट इज वॉट यू गेट फॉर पुटिंग इन हार्ड यार्ड्स विद नो बडी इज वॉचिंग गॉड इवेंचुअली ब्लेसेस यू विद सक्सेस देन कुमार कुशाग्रा एज एट सेट 7.2 करोड़ रुपीज हैरी ब्रूक वॉज रिलीज बाय सनराइजर्स हैदराबाद एंड ही वॉज पिक्ड अप बाय डेली कैपिटल्स फॉर 4 करोड़ रुपीज ही विल बैट इन द मिडल ऑर्डर एज हैज बीन स्पेसिफाइड बाय द हेड कोच मिस्टर रिकी पॉन्टिंग सुमित कुमार हु इज अ बैकअप फॉर ऋषभ पंत हु हैज स्टेट हु हैज परफॉर्म प्रिटी वेल इन द इंडियन डोमेस्टिक सर्किट ही हैज बीन पिक्ड अप बाय 1 करोड़ रुपीज फॉर डेली कैपिटल्स रायली रूसो अ फ्रीलांसर विद एक्सेलेंट पोटेंशियल बट नॉट हैज ऑलवेज डिड जस्टिस टू हिज पोटेंशियल बट पंजाब किंग्स हैज पुट अ बिग बेट ऑन हिम 8 करोड़ रुपीज ही इज अ T20 freelancer now. He represents South Africa in the T20 format. Chris Wokes went for 4.2 crores to Punjab Kings. That is a fair enough price. Spencer Johnson, I think it was the biggest payday of his life, who has impressed one and all with his exploits in the Big Bash League. For the past couple of years, he has done well for Australia in the T20 format as well. He went for a whopping 10 crore. Gujarat Titans paid for his services. Gujarat Titans also picked up Umesh Yadav for 5.8 crores. Good to see that Umesh Yadav is currently in the reckoning. As we know that he has been overlooked for the central contract. But he is still bowling pretty well with all the josh for Vidarbha in the Ranji Trophy. And hopefully he comes back into the selectors reckoning in the IPL. शिवम मावी ऑल्सो ही हैड अ बिग पेडे 6.4 करोड़ रुपए, पिकड अप बाय लखनऊ सुपर जायंट. मणिमरन सिद्धार्थ हु इज एक्चुअली द फास्ट बॉलर फ्रॉम तमिलनाडु वेंट फॉर 2 करोड़ रुपीज टू लखनऊ सुपर जायंट. एश्टन टर्नर पिकड अप एज अ बैकअप बाय लखनऊ सुपर जायंट एज अ बार्गेन जस्ट 1 करोड़ रुपीज. यश दयाल वेंट फॉर 5 करोड़ फॉर RCB. नाउ मेनी RCB फैंस स्टार्टेड ट्रोलिंग यश दयाल, बट वी हैव टू टेक इन टू कंसिडरेशन दैट वन परफॉर्मेंस डज नॉट डिफाइन एन इंडिविजुअल्स करियर. यश दयाल हैड वॉज एक्सट्रीमली हार्ड टू गेट दैट स्टेज ऑल्सो. ही शुडंट बी डिफाइंड बाय दोज 5 सिक्सेस बाय रिंकू सिंह एंड होपफुली यश दयाल विल प्रूव ऑल हिज डाउटर्स रॉन्ग इन दिस IPL बाय परफॉर्मिंग एक्सीडिंगली वेल. लॉकी फर्गसन ऑल्सो वेंट फॉर 2 करोड़ बाय द RCB. वी ऑल नो दैट लॉकी फर्गसन ब्रिंग्स एक्सट्रीम पेस टू द टेबल, ग्रेट यॉर्कर्स एज वेल, एक्सिलेंट एक्सपोनेंट ऑफ रिवर्स स्विंग इन द लास्ट ओवर्स, सो दैट्स अ प्रीटी चीप बाय आई वुड से. एंड टॉम करन हु वॉज द मोस्ट एक्सपेंसिव इन द ऑक्शन कपल ऑफ ईयर्स अगो फॉर मोर देन 18 करोड़, जस्ट वेंट फॉर 1.5 करोड़ इन द RCB. So all in all, a great auction, and we don't have to forget that many of the players who didn't find any buyers. That is the dynamic of international cricket. A domestic cricketer with just 2-3 year experience can go for crores of rupees, but as international player like Tabrez Shamsi or even for the likes of Steve Smith are not find the buyers due to that the franchises actually don't need them. So it is a game of supply and demand. Whatever skill set you bring to the table, if you satisfy that, even if you are a first class cricketer in India, you will earn 100 times more as compared to the international cricketer, and vice versa. So Karun Nair, who had a base price of just 50 lakh rupees, who wasn't sold at all. Steve Smith was one of the most eye-catching players that didn't find any buyer in the auction, but that is despite the fact that he turned down pretty well for the Sydney Sixers. He has increased his strike rate manifold for the past 2 seasons. Still, there is a perception about Steve Smith that his strike rate is not as high as it want to be in the T20 format. So that's the reason many teams didn't bid for him. 2 crore rupees was his bid price. Base price. Phil Salt was actually pretty interesting. I think even one team could have picked him up as a backup option. He performed exceedingly well for the limited opportunities Delhi Capital gave him last year, but they released him. His base price was 1.5 crore. Josh English at the base price of 2 crore didn't find any takers as well. Kushal Mendis, who performed exceedingly well in the World Cup for Sri Lanka, 50 lakh rupees. Adil Rashid, 2 crore base price, once again nobody there. Is Sodi was unsold. Kamlesh Nagarkoti was unsold, so that is a bit of a bummer for him, as we know that he has been going through a plethora of injuries. Sandeep Warrier, who has performed exceedingly well in the first class cricket in India, 50 lakh, no takers. Tamal Mills, T20 specialist who turned up for RCB as well, couldn't find any takers at well at 1.5 crore. Murugan Ashwin also didn't find any takers, unfortunately. Over the years, he has turned up for many franchises, but consistency has always been his bane. 20 lakh rupees. Finn Allen, I think that's a bit of a shocker as well. Just 75 lakh rupees base price, but he didn't fit in any team's plan. Akhil Hussain, who has performed exceedingly well for the West Indies, as well as in the CPL, BBL and various T20 franchises, including the PSL as well, couldn't find any takers. Tabrez Shamsi for 50 lakhs didn't find any takers. Luke Wood, the English fast bowler, has also impressed one and all with his exploits in the T20 circuit. He's playing as a freelancer. He made his debut for England as well in the T20 format. He also didn't get any team. Adam Milne for rupees 1 crore also couldn't find any buyers. Matt Henry was a bit of a shocker as well. 75 lakh base price. Also, he didn't find any takers. Colin Munro, whose star has been on little bit of decline. As we know that he can perform well in Big Bash League or the small leagues like the Pakistan Super League, but he couldn't impress one and all in the IPL. Consistency has always been his problem. And Rasi Wanders Dusan was also a bit of a shocker. Just 2 crore rupees base price and no team picked him. Ravman Pavel, I actually forgot to tell, also went for rupees 7.5 crore to Rajasthan Royals. They are also looking for a finisher and the middle order batsman that could satisfy their criteria. So, how did you like my analysis of these players and the overall IPL auction? Please tell me without forgetting in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everybody. Bye.